Hey guys, welcome back. So initially we did not plan to make this video until we had some solid proof and guaranteed information.
But since there could be major changes to the Express Entry program, so we wanted you to be on a lookout in advance so that you don't miss your chances to immigrate to Canada. So my name is Tanu.
And I'm Nishant, and let's get started. The Immigration Minister in one of the recent press conferences said that there would be changes in the Immigration and Refugee Protection Act so that they can better target and tap the candidates who can meet the labour market needs of Canada.
So basically it means that the majority of the people who are coming through the Express Entry are not the best fit as per the Canadian labour market. So they will be making changes so as to target different types of people.
So before the Express Entry system, there used to be a grid system where you needed to get 67 points to be eligible to apply for the PR. And also along with that, there used to be a list of specific knock codes which are allowed to apply for the PR. So it was not very open. But when the Express Entry came, the entire process became a lot more open. So anyone with a knock code with a skill level of 0, A or B can apply for the PR as long as they meet the 67 grid point.
But then age has become a major issue. Because in the current Express Entry program, as soon as you turn 30 or more, you start losing a lot of points. And which basically means that a lot of younger people are getting PR regardless of their profession, which is good. But if you look at it from a different perspective, this also means if you are younger, you do have less work experience.
But Canada feels that there are a lot of jobs available in their job market for which they need more experienced professionals. Hence, the current Express Entry system may not be serving well. Also, in the current Express Entry system, there is no way to filter out any specific profession unless you are coming through a specific provincial nominee program. Hence, you might see some changes where they may want to address this particular concern. So Canada may increase points for the experience. And if that happens, then these changes could turn out to be positive for the people older than 30. But at the same time, these changes can also go on the negative side for a lot of people who are less experienced.
And what they might do is they might make it more restrictive like it was earlier and allow only people from certain knock codes to apply in Express Entry.
Or there is another theory that instead of coming out with a list of specific knock codes which can apply, what they can do is that they can come up with a list of ineligible occupations which cannot apply.
But as of now, all these are speculations. Nothing is confirmed yet. The only thing confirmed is that there are going to be changes to Express Entry and these changes could be big.
Now, apart from the experience point of view, there were a few other things that were reported. One being that as per the statistics, more of the primary applicants are male. So they may want to address this concern as well and level that up. So you might see changes like females getting more points or something. But again, this is just in the air and nothing is solid yet.
Now coming to the good news, Canada is reopening. A lot of provinces have shared their reopening plan and most of them are starting to reopen in the first week of June. And then after every 2 to 3 weeks, they might ease up more restrictions. So the expectation is that by August or September, everything will be open. Even colleges might start their classes in person and the immigration process will also speed up.
But it is advisable that to give yourself a good chance, please get yourself vaccinated if you haven't already, because the chances are that for the safety purpose, there could be a condition that only those people will be accepted who have been vaccinated. So please get yourself vaccinated and we'll keep you updated as soon as there is any confirmation on the immigration changes.
And subscribe to the channel if you want to learn more about Canada immigration, life in Canada and jobs in Canada. We cover all these topics.
And don't forget to press the bell icon and we'll see you in our next video. Till then, take care and stay safe.